One of the hardest things when first starting off your channel is figuring out how to create emotes. You got to look into who to commission, what style you want. Do I even have enough money to do it? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can easy create Twitch emotes using Bing Image Creator. If you're not familiar with Bing Image Creator, it's a free online tool that uses OpenAI's DALL-E model to generate images purely through text. And by the end of this video, you'll be creating your own Twitch emotes in minutes and hopefully uploading them to your channel where the rest of your community can enjoy them. Let me show you how it's done. So to use Bing Image Creator, the first thing you need to do is go to bing.com/create and sign in with a Microsoft account. Then click on the text field right here and enter a description of an image you would like to see. So for example, smiling cat wearing sunglasses. You can click enter or click create, and then you're going to start generating your image right away. Bing Image Creator will generate 4 images based on the text you inputted using OpenAI's DALL-E model. The more detailed description you give it, the better results you're going to get. You can also choose different styles and images such as comic, sketch, realistic, chibi, etc. by adding it at the end of it. So we can see right here, we got 4 images with a cat. If we add a comma at the end and we say chibi, click create again, I'll start generating 4 images now with chibi at the end of it. And we can see we got 4 new cats. Pretty cool. Now here comes the hardest part. Trying to decide what emotes to make. When trying to decide what sort of emotes to make, consider what sort of inside jokes or catchphrases are occurring in your channel, or think about what sort of moments you want to capture and exciting things that you might be able to enhance using emotes. Or you can lean on your community and try doing polls to figure out what sort of emotes they might want to see. Or you can simply just try generating a bunch of different emotes and showing it to your chat and figuring out which ones they like the best through polls. Generating emotes is going to be really simple. So use trial and error, try different sorts of emotions, try different sorts of style, tweak the description ever so slightly to see what sort of output you can get. No one image is ever going to be truly the same, even using the same description. You'll just have to keep on iterating through until you get the emote that suits you best. But don't let perfection get in the way of what might be just a perfectly good emote to share on your channel in the meantime. Once you've generated a set of images you like for your emote, all you have to do is click on one of the images and click the download button, and that will download straight to your computer for where you can start doing additional editing to meet Twitch's criteria. Twitch requires that your images not have a background and meet a specific sizing standard. If your image does contain a background, you can specify in the description when you're generating the emotes that you only want a white background. And this will make it much easier for you to use a tool that removes backgrounds from images. You can easily search for one on the internet and put your image in and get the background removed. For example, these 2 images, one on the right is one with the background and one on the left is with the background removed. And all I used was the first result from a simple search for removing backgrounds from an image. Once you remove the background, now you're all set to upload your images. And congratulations, you just created your own Twitch emotes with Bing Image Creator in minutes. Hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you like this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up. And if you're not already following the channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button. And I love to see the images that you create using Bing Image Creator. So if you have anything you want to show off, consider tagging me on Twitter with @talktomegooseman and show me what you made. I'll catch you in the next one.